Hey everyone, I'm Yashel, and in this video I want to talk about a new ARPG called Treasure Tile. Like always, I'm sorry for my bad English, and sorry if I have to say that in every video, but if someone watch this video or one of my video, they must know that I'm Italian, and for this reason I don't speak a perfect English. Said that in this video, like I said, I want to talk about Treasure Tile, that is a very different, unique ARPG. Like you can see from the video, the game is basically a Diablo with tiles. And that's all. And no, that's not all. I think that this unique feature is something that makes the game more funny and also more relaxing. Not because you don't have any difficulty. In fact, you can easily be killed if you don't watch where you are going, because you can be close to a lot of mob, and that will be the end. But I was saying that because when you move around all the area, you can feel that you are make progress, because you can level up very easily. So maybe if some mob maybe has killed you before, you can beat that mob without farming a lot. And there is also the fact that in my case I can use the tiles to be advanced with some mobs, because I have arranged the character, so that can be more easy. And there is also then the fact that you can see how strong the mobs are from their color of the tiles. So, for example, if you have a sort of boss, you can see that the boss is the tile of the boss is colored in red. Also, some mob that are more stronger than others can have the fact that the silver color about their tiles is more enchanted. So from the most, these are the difference that I've noted. Another thing about what I was saying is the fact that you can easily play this game on controller. For me, that I love playing game on controller, because there are only a few key, and also the way you can move around the area is pretty simple. And I think that it can be a very cool game to play with controller and on console. Some other thing that I can say about the game is that I've tried the game for like 2 hours. I tried the first another run that I've deleted because I didn't understand that with the ranged character I can kill enemies from distance, because I'm stupid. And so for this reason I was dying a lot, and so I played again everything, but I only make a few quests, not all the quests from the demo. Anyway, I can say for sure that when you play this game, you can see that your efforts are well repaired because, for example, you can replay every area because every area is random generated, and maybe you can find more loot in a simple area and then proceed to another area. This can be a very good system if you want to try to do a full run with the demo. And with this, okay, say with this method, I found very easy to kill the most stronger mob and the red ones too. So what about the loot system? I think that the loot system is okay. It is normal. I mean, usually in this kind of games, you are very focused on the loot system. But I think that for now there are only a few things, so I think also that the loot is not the primary thing in this game, at least for now. But it is more based on dodging, you move around the area and around the various tiles. Like I said, there is the fact that areas are random generated, so you don't have a map to follow. And if you, for example, I found an item in that location, you might non find that item. If you die, you might not find that item in that exact location. So you have to clear the map. Also because if you not clear the map, you can easily die. And for the most, you have, like I said, to be very careful and to use your potion when you are in need. Don't waste that because you will need when you need that it recharge only with every kill. And that's all for the most. That's all. I think also that this game is, like I said before, very relaxing because you can easily play this game for 2 hours and never be ashamed of that, because there are hours well spent. So yeah, I think that's all. See you soon. Bye.